Okay. Show me.
What's up YouTube, Dutch C in the house, thank you very much for tuning in for an update on this quadcopter, the Isine LAL5, a monstrously powerful quadcopter, and that's mostly due to its enormous motors. What are these? These are 2507 motors, which is far bigger than we are used to, isn't it? Yeah, so I did a review of this quadcopter already couple of weeks ago, and I wasn't very positive about this quadcopter. Now, I told you that it could just be mine, the one I have, that's faulty, but since then I've come to the conclusion that it's not. I've been working on this quadcopter a little, and it is a lot better by now. Actually, by now I'd say it might be a recommended quadcopter actually, because it's one, it's very powerful, it produces nice video, courtesy of the KEDEX Target version 2, and I also like its looks, and it definitely flies a lot better by now. So what happened? Actually, let me first show you what it flies like now. So this is an onboard recording, 2.7K, and it's scaled down to 1080p for this review video or this update video. So I am quite happy with the recordings of this KEDEX Target version 2. So yeah, mine actually works 100% correct as of now. As you can probably see, the color rendering is nice and it's nice and sharp. The FEV feed also looks pretty good. Actually very good. KEDEX Target's are known for that, right? They record reasonably good video and their FEV feed is great. So is what you see here completely perfect? No, there are some little propwash oscillations here and there still. I'd say that 95% of what you see here can be tuned out. And I'm not saying 100%. I'd say that most of it can be tuned away. The rest you can fly around just like on most other quadcopters. There's still a little bit of yaw oscillation sometimes, but only at low throttle somehow. I'm not sure why, but yeah, probably you can tune that away. So obviously you tell me what you think, but by now I think this recording looks pretty good for an untuned quad. Again, you tell me what you think. Now, I'll leave you with the rest of this recording, and at the end of the recording I'll actually show you what I did, what I altered on the LAL5 to improve it. So, enjoy, and see you back in a minute. Okay, and the last thing I want to show you is the last part or the summary of my DVR, in which you can see the total or the max amp draw. And as you can see, that's nothing to sniff about. 124 amps, that's quite a lot, right? For a 6S quadcopter, you fly 6S to keep the amps low. And for a quadcopter that doesn't have a GoPro or anything on it, that's quite a lot. Yeah, that's what big motors will do to your amp draw. You do get a lot of performance for your 124 amps. So I'm okay with it, right? It's not like I didn't know it wouldn't draw a lot of amps, this quadcopter. So the next thing is, what did I actually change on this quadcopter? Well, it turns out that I actually made a mistake on this quadcopter when I got it. See, whenever I get a new quadcopter in, I check all the screws, right? And I torque them down to within an inch of their life. So when I got to these four, well, 16, four motors, right? These four screws that hold on the motors, I found that these weren't torqued down much at all. It's not like the motor was wobbling all over the place, but these screws, if you have this quadcopter, you will probably find that these screws are not torqued down very far. So yeah, like I always do, I did torque them down. Yeah, so I think that was a major part of the reason why my quadcopter was wobbly. See, because I torqued these screws down, more of the vibrations were translated into the to the rest of the frame. And I'm not sure, it's probably by design, because the stack, the flight controller, isn't soft mounted, that they opted for this, well, solutions. Is it a solution? I'm not sure. But by now I backed them out a little again, approximately a full turn for each screw, actually. And if you are wondering if you now need to use thread lock, I don't think so. The screws are pretty much secured in place by this sticky TPU. Maybe you should check it, but well, I've done four flights after I backed the screws out one turn and they are still in. And all motors are still securely in place. So yeah, I don't think you need to add thread lock. So that improved the quadcopter quite a lot. I'm not sure if the tension on my screws is now identical to what it was when I got the quad in, but I suspect it is. Again, if you get this quadcopter and you find that these screws aren't tight, probably by design. Now, in all my videos about this quadcopter, I complained about the stack, the flight controller and ESC stack, not being soft mounted. They are simply mounted with plastic risers or standoffs, which is not really how we nowadays build quadcopters. In all my builds, I use bolts that run through the entire stack with silicone washers to dampen or vibration isolate the flight controller. And I'd still say that would be a great upgrade for this quadcopter. Either by de-easing itself, or if you order this quadcopter, and again, I think it's by now a nice quadcopter, soft mounting your flight controller is still a great upgrade. You'd probably get rid of the yaw oscillations you saw in my flight video. Those would probably be all gone just by soft mounting your flight controller. So that's the tip I have for you. And other than that, I'd say go ahead and order this quadcopter. It is fun to fly. It's super powerful. And that's definitely nice. You do need a larger field for a quadcopter like this. If you're used to flying 3-inch quadcopters, well, actually 3-inch quadcopters nowadays are pretty fast as well. If you are used to less powerful 4S quadcopters, Yeah, you might be taken off guard by the power of this quadcopter. It has big motors, it flies on 6S, and these propellers, the Dall Cyclones, are pretty fast propellers as well. So, yeah, be careful where you fly a quadcopter like this. So, that's basically it. Long story short, partly a mistake of mine by torquing those screws down of the motors. Well, I created a problem. And partly, well, again, I think Isshin should fit this quadcopter out with a vibration-isolated flight controller. Or if you are still interested in this quadcopter and, well, again, powerful quadcopter, quite a lot of fun. It's a relatively easy upgrade. And not a costly upgrade either. You don't need to swap out electronics, change out electronics. Yeah, so with a little bit of work, you'll probably have a great quadcopter. If you are left with questions, hit me up a comment down below. Catch you on the next video. Bye bye.